be feasting tonight, we will. Watch thanks.
You'll be fine.
Walk on, girl.
Is everything all right?
No need to ask twice. Ooh.
I trust that you had a productive meeting with Mr. Owen.
Oh, yes. We had a most wonderful chat. I found out the man behind Staric's soothing syrup is John Elliotson.
Dr. Elliotson? I haven't heard that name in a long while. He was a brilliant heart specialist until he became obsessed with phrenology and mesmerism. It ruined his career. Well, how shall we proceed?
Oh, with all respect, Mr. Darwin, I believe I should proceed alone. After all, we wouldn't want to attract any unwanted attention.
Sounds very wise. Good luck, my boy. Oh, and Mr. Fry, should you find yourself with any free time, please do call on me.
Keep your eyes peeled for trouble.
Hold an apple.
Oh, I got.
Where would I find the doctor?
As you've just witnessed, the application of too much pressure can sometimes result in unexpected outcomes. Unfortunately, it appears I've ruined the organ. Send up a cadaver.
At once, Dr. Linson.
Oh!
I don't care about your ethics. And I care even less about your damn patience. Now hand over your keys.
What are you doing?
Haven't you heard? You're fired. Now bugger off.
What's the matter?
Oh, young man, help. I must speak with Miss Nightingale at once. One of the brutes stole my key, and there's no one around. I can't get out of here.
Stole your key? Don't go anywhere. Be able to do something.
Oh, quite. Thank you, sir. Well, you'll know where to find me, sir. Go on now, sir. I will wait here.
Tells her to bugger off, but she can't get out without her key.
Oh, she'll report him to Miss Nightingale, you know.
But also how to measure the mental faculties of the patients. For instance, this specimen's overdeveloped organs found on either side of the lower back of its head. The protuberances previously measured establish the correctness of both police records and medical observation. I am, of course, referring to the specimen's tendency to provoke assault and desirable propensities which were wholly suppressed by the use of the soothing syrup. Despite the specimen's violent reaction to the procedure, the soothing syrup anesthetized its senses and it died without suffering. What you have just witnessed is nothing less than the undeniable effectiveness of the medicine.
Have some of this!
line of work.
Trespasser! Hit him! That's it! Playtime's over!
I must be. You have my gratitude, sir. I shall inform Miss Nightingale that I'll not be working for this asylum ever again.
Him.
Where's he from then? We have an intruder! Take the bastard!
Thank you.
Here it is, Doctor.
We will continue our experiment shortly. In a moment, we will compare the brains of our two specimens. Since both specimens had a propensity towards violent behavior, we should see similar protrusions in specific parts of their brains. Corpses do not have boots. It ends. Yet I can only think of beginnings. A better tomorrow, forged with the blood of visionaries.
All I see is the blood of a lunatic.
Do you truly believe murdering an old man will stop humanity's great architect? Crawford Starrick has a glorious design for mankind.
Designs are meant to be broken.
You're a child. A child who believes they can solve all the world's woes with a flick of a blade. Have you ever pondered the consequences of your actions, Jacob Fry? Or did your father teach you nothing?
That's the way. Steady on.
Elliot's an expired, and soothing syrup production has ceased. Outrageous!
Fry intends to endanger all of London at the hands of the mob.
Or perhaps he doesn't intend much of anything at all.
Thank you.
He's simply content to dice with our lives.
The asylum is shut up. Medical care throughout the city is in disarray. He does not, cannot understand the consequences of his actions. The man is clearly an anarchist.
Gentlemen. This tea was brought to me from India by a ship. And up from the harbor to a factory, where it was packaged and ferried by carriage to my door. Unpacked in the larder and brought upstairs to me. All by men and women who work for me. Who are indebted to me, Crawford Starrick. For their jobs, the time, the very lives they lead. They will work in my factories, and so too shall their children. And you come to me with talk of this Jacob Fry. This insignificant blemish who calls himself assassin? You disrespect the very city that works day and night so that we may drink this. This miracle, this tea.
I'm nearing the end of my research. Our beloved London shall not suffer such a bothersome fool for much longer.
And what of this sister I've heard of? Miss Fry.
Miss Fry shall be gutted. Soon enough. Delicious.
Sorry to interrupt, Initiate. Thought you'd like to know that Sean and Rebecca got away from Otzoberg. Berg runs a unit called Sigma Team. Violet DaCosta is his tech support. They've been hunting and killing assassins for a long time. God you're all right.
Oh, tish tosh. It'll take more than a Templar super soldier to end the glorious saga of Sean Danger Hastings.
I was talking to Rebecca.
Right. Anyway, Berg's presence confirms it. The Peace of Eden is in London.
The Initiate's data sync suggests it's the Shroud.
The Templars seem to want it pretty bad all of a sudden. They must know something we don't.
The only thing we know is that we can't go up against Sigma Team alone.
Leave that to me. In the meantime, keep a low profile. Let the Initiate continue to sync the data.